If there's not a form, then there's immediate problem. There's a derailment. And now the attorneys then would come up with their own form or their own petition and try to track the language of the statute. I guess you can do it too. I don't want to tell you to do that because I don't want to walk you into the unlicensed practice of law and have some mad lawyer that thinks you're sucking up their business get mad at you and want to charge you with a third-degree felony. And I know it is a tight line you have to kind of dance on whether you're actually giving legal advice or not. In St. John's County, we have our legal aid. We have pretty good legal aid. They work out of Jacksonville area legal aid. And we have two clinics a month. One is a form signing clinic. And then the second one is a form, a legal advice clinic once you filled out the form. So we have volunteer lawyers that show up to help them fill out the forms and then give them legal advice. And that's one thing I want to talk to you just briefly about. The form, a petition to relocate, a petition for dissolution of marriage, a petition for paternity. Call me out some other petition that you think I will hear on a regular basis that you prepare.
Paternity.
Modification.
Modification of child support, alimony. Okay. Why?
Because
she is cohabiting.
Name change.
A petition for name change.
Visitation.
A petition for visitation.
Custody.
Well, we don't use that term anymore now. It's all time sharing. Your primary time share or your secondary time share. Well, we know what it is. It's custody. You don't have a conference at the coffee pot at work and say, my husband's trying to get time sharing for me. He's trying to get custody of me. Okay. So, you're in the people business. I'm in the people business. We deal with people. The forms that you help them fill out are not evidence. They are not evidence. They only get you the hearing. And there is often a fundamental misunderstanding. I wish you could come to the hearing and watch what happens when you help someone fill out a form and then they come to the hearing for which the form granted them the hearing, but the form does not admit the evidence. The form does not waive the hearsay rules. The form does not tell them how to proceed on their case. No one mentioned a petition for injunction for protection against domestic violence. The big daddy. We got that all the time. And now when the police won't arrest the annoying neighbor, keeps annoying you, then we have petitions for stalking. Cyber stalking. Stalking and cyber stalking. Man, this is fertile ground. I get it all the time. And I usually write a note back and say, if the police wouldn't arrest him for stalking, why is this stalking? And they'll say, Judge, because the police won't arrest them. Well, maybe it's not stalking because the police won't arrest them. Okay? But that's our job. We got to figure it out. Okay. The forms aren't evidence. So in other words, when someone comes into court, let me walk you through it. Maybe many of you know this. Maybe some don't. A petition for dissolution of marriage. I had a lady come in, and someone helped her fill out the forms. And if she would just follow the forms and read them and put her evidence on, paragraph 1, 2, 3, for instance, I swear to tell the truth, Your Honor, my name is Mary Jones. I was married on June 15th, 2008. My marriage is irretrievably broken. These are all the paragraphs you're helping them fill out. I've been a resident of the state of Florida for at least 6 months prior to filing this petition. Okay, that's good enough. But they don't know to do that. Well, Judge, I filled out the form. Don't I get a divorce? And I want alimony, too. Well, alimony has 8 separate criteria. Standard of living invoked during the marriage. It's got all these separate criteria. They never talk about any of that. So I had a lady come to me, and I case manage everything. Okay, so if you have someone file a divorce today, or if you filed a divorce, if you're going through a divorce, in St. John's County today, sometime in the middle of October, you'll be required to come to a case management hearing. And the other side will be required to come. And it's mandatory. I do it in the jury room. Judge, can I appear by telephone? No. I'm big, no. My mother told me no. I've been married 38 years. I know all about no. All right, no. Why do I want them there? I want them there because I can't get anything settled unless both parties are there. I dearly love the person in Texas filing a divorce in Florida. Judge, I can't come to the hearing. I live in Texas. Well, then file in Texas. But you're not going to park your case on my docket and then not come. You got to have some skin in the game, so to speak. So she says, I want alimony and I want child support. And I'd warned her at case management 3 weeks earlier, I don't think you're competent to represent yourself. Oh, I know. I've talked to a lawyer. I've talked to my paralegal to help me fill out these forms. I'm thinking, well, paralegal's not supposed to be giving you legal advice, but we know it happens. And I said, and she goes, I want alimony. I want $1,500 a month. And now, let me go back a minute. Here's how it started. My name is Mary Jones. Judge, I want alimony. I want child support. I want to be divorced. Ms. Jones, anything else? No, that's it, Judge. I want to be divorced. Okay. And she says, how soon will I get the order? I said, oh, very soon. You're going to get it very soon. Okay. And I entered the order. She didn't prove. She didn't tell me when she was married, the date of the marriage. She didn't name any of her children born during the marriage. She didn't tell me her marriage was irretrievably broken. She didn't tell me she was a resident of the state of Florida for at least 6 months prior to filing. She didn't tell me any of the statutory criteria for alimony, and certainly didn't tell me any of the 22 statutory criteria for primary residence, what we affectionately known as custody, 16113 sub 3A through T. Kind of know these things by heart. So I entered an order, didn't tell her, said, thank you very much, ma'am, you get your order in the mail in 2 days. Went back to my office, usually after 4 o'clock, where I do most of my dictation, and dictated order of dismissal without prejudice, because nothing was proven on the record other than her name. Okay? Why? The petition is not evidence. She's got to testify under oath who she is. She's got to testify, or he. And so there is a common misconception. You can often help the judge, and your efforts will be appreciated if you let them know. Now, this petition gets you the hearing. It doesn't put anything into evidence. It doesn't give its testimony on its own. It only establishes the proceeding for which you are to give sworn testimony at the proceeding. Okay? So, make sure that you're using the latest form in compliance with the statute. If there isn't a form approved by the Supreme Court, then track the statute. Come up with your own form. That's the one thing I can tell you. Because sometimes the forms committee are half a year to a year behind the enactment of the statute. Sometimes we don't know the statute is enacted until the third week of June when the session finishes. July 1, you can get a form out by then. From the forms committee, we got to meet. We meet by telephone between 5 and 6 o'clock in the evening, usually on Wednesdays of the month, from all around the state. And we work on the specific language in the form. So, latest form in compliance with the statute. And here's one thing from my standpoint. I had a lady one time trying to do her own adoption. She was trying to adopt these children. She had no idea about service. I don't know where the father is. You dump the kids with me, why should I have to serve you? He tells, ma'am, every lawsuit, every one, 100%, all 100, you can answer this as a true question if you were taking a government class. All cases have to have service, every one of them. You got to serve them. You can't have a final hearing if you haven't served. I mean, this is what a lawsuit's about. You're suing someone. If the someone doesn't know they're being sued and hadn't been served, how does the court have any jurisdiction over them? You got to serve them. And Rule 1.070J, which came out in the late 1980s, requires service to be within 120 days of filing. So I'm going to case manage it in the middle of October and say, where's your service? I don't know how to serve. I don't know how to get him served. He's living in New York. Well, there's constructive service. by publication, notice of action. You got to get him served, ma'am. I'm going to put the next case management in the middle of November. You filed in early September. We're getting close to 120 days if we haven't hit it already. If you haven't served him, guess what I'm doing? Dismissing the case. I'm not going to let him park hundreds and thousands of cases because the Supreme Court has a clock for every judge, and you're judged internally by the Supreme Court on how you're resolving cases. We're supposed to resolve divorce cases within 180 days, not of service, 180 days of filing. So that's why the judges are on people hard. You got to get the other side served because that clock is running whether you serve them or not. Okay, forms catch up to the statute, not if you say, well, this is a Supreme Court approved form, but the statute has changed, the person's going to walk in and get their head handed to them by the judge, assuming the judge knows the law. Never an assumption you should always make, okay? All right, and forms aren't evidence. The forms don't waive hearsay, okay? That means the person, the rules of evidence apply. The forms get you the hearing, but the hearing, the devil can be in the details. So that's just something to think about. It's never wrong to encourage someone, at the very least, seek the advice of a lawyer. You're helping them fill out the form to get them the hearing. It is not your responsibility to advise them on how the hearing goes, what they should do at the hearing. That's a lawyer's responsibility. That's what lawyers are supposed to do, assuming the lawyers know what to do. And there's been some lawyers in front of me. I had to ask them, you know, can you tell me when you took the bar exam? I'm not even going to ask you whether you passed it or not, but just when did you take it, okay? So those are some basic things from a judge's standpoint. Now, if you've got the client that writes on an angle that the judge has to cock his head to try to read, I'm not doing it, okay? I'm going to send it back and say this is not legible. Remember, the rules require pleading a plain statement of fact. In a petition for divorce, if you're helping them fill it out, you've got the forms, don't put in there, he cheated on me 30 times in this year, and then 44 times, and then marry that little trollop redhead. Yeah. Well, just, I don't want to hear all that. I mean, what's that going to do? It's not evidence, okay? It's not a plain statement of fact. I'm probably going to knock it out and tell her to amend it. Get the garbage out of your pleadings. Tell me your marriage is irretrievably broken. You've been a resident from the state of Florida. Date your marriage. When were you married? Often they can't agree on the date of marriage. So that's always a good one. That's usually headed for divorce. Okay. And write legibly. They can't write. Maybe you will be a mission of mercy and you will type it out for them. Now, I'm not telling you anything you all haven't seen yourself. I'm sure you've seen writing that you thought immediately was Egyptian hieroglyphics. Here's the paper. Tell them, please do not write in the margins with arrows directed this way, that way, and that. I'm not following the arrows. Plain statement of fact. In other words, they confuse what evidence they have to prove. They think they have to put all that in their petition. No, petition's not evidence. Petition is only that that gets you to the arena. It's not the arena. Of course, they don't understand that. So you can always tell them, judge doesn't want that in the petition. That may be a relevant matter to prove at hearing, but it doesn't need to. Now, do you have to ask for alimony? Sure. Do you have to ask for child support? Sure. Do you have to ask for primary residence? Sure. But you don't need to put in there, I'm asking for primary residence because on the following 14 occasions, he failed to pick up the children from school, and that doesn't need to be in there. Plain statement of ultimate facts. You had a question?
Yes, sir. You may want me to wait until later, but would you address the answer waiver request for copy of final judgment form and our use of that? Also,
That's fine. I mean, assuming, now, remember, you got to be served. I'm sure you're asking that in regard to being served. If my wife and I were going through a divorce and I don't want to have the deputy come to my house, because they do come to my house, I sign warrants at night, and I'm sure the neighbors go, oh, Alexander, he's been married a long time. There's a deputy at his house. That damn deputy's been here a lot lately, okay? So when I'm on call every fifth week, I'm signing warrants at night. An answer waives a right to be served. Okay, so if you file an answer, there's no need for service. Okay, so if someone says answer, they request a copy, that's going to be the clerk's responsibility to send them the final judgment. Now, if you prepare the final judgment for the client, please make sure you filled it out fully, including the circuit, the county. Give me a big city one of you all work in.
Tampa.
Okay, good example. So you work in Tampa, but the person's getting divorced in St. Petersburg. Are you going to put Hillsborough County up in the top? No, you can put Pinellas, right?
Yeah.
See, I'm in the bedroom community of Jacksonville. So they have here in Duval County, Jacksonville, Florida. So I take a big red magic marker to let the paralegal or a lawyer that filled it out know this is St. John's County, St. Augustine. And I always write it real big. Like if it's this big, Duval, I write St. John's. I wanted to get back, I don't know who prepared, maybe they did them themselves, but I wanted to get the county and the city right, yes.
Well, if we had done a disclosure from a non-lawyer and at the bottom of the form we assisted with put our information on that, wouldn't you turn to that and see who did it? Or,
yeah, probably. But I often don't, because you know what? It's not my responsibility. It's their responsibility. And it's not my responsibility to send out orders. It's actually the clerk of court's responsibility. But answer waiver, I just tell my case manager, noted, listen, you know, we've got a final judgment here prepared, and I'm going to fill it out. Copies, those are wonderful. So when someone brings an original to sign, my judicial assistant goes, it's not my job to have to make copies for people. They should be bringing their own copies. Then we can stamp them, and then they have a copy. And then the way we do it in St. John's County, if we're in actual in court, we scan it, and then they go down to family division. They can pick up a certified copy within seconds, literally. But we don't do the certified copies in the courtroom. Yes? Court's not going to transfer a case to Wisconsin. She can take a voluntary dismissal and refile. I'm not transferring a case out of state. Who do I know is going to pick it up in Wisconsin? The laws are different. And then she pled a Florida cause of action, not a Wisconsin. What if the Wisconsin action is 12 months residency? What if a North Carolina action is you have to live separately and you got to plead that for 12 months before you file? How did I find that out? To Charlotte City residents come to St. John's County, file for divorce. Judge, he needs to be paying the Time Warner cable bill. I go, we don't have a Time Warner in St. John's County. I'm talking about in Charlotte.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking to myself, and there's two attorneys. And the water bill for the Charlotte utilities is such and such. About 10 minutes of that. Stop. Where's the marital abode? Charlotte. Where's the business? Charlotte. What am I doing here and what are y'all doing here? Well, Judge, they have a house here in St. John's County. Is it rental property? Yes. I don't have jurisdiction, folks. Judge, we've stipulated the jurisdiction. You cannot stipulate that 2 + 2 = 5. I don't care. You can get the Pope to sanction it. You cannot stipulate that 1 + 1 = 3. Doesn't work. You got to be a resident of the state of Florida for 6 months prior to filing. Why were they doing that? Because they have to live apart for a year in North Carolina. My staff attorneys from North Carolina told me that. You learn something new every day. So I knew what they were trying to do. I dismissed their case. They took an appeal, procuring a firm. No, you cannot create jurisdiction for the court where the court does not have any.